What do you want? Tangibles. What you gonna get? Nothing!
Now available in paperback and Kindle, Vampires Stalk the Darkness of the Eternal Night. Get your copy of Eternal Night in paperback and Kindle on Amazon.com.
Joe Biden was projected to be the next president of the United States, winning the 2020 election this Saturday. And on this confirmation of Joe Biden being projected to be the 46th president of the United States, we had all of these black folks taking to the streets, hooping, hollering, and celebrating. And when I looked at these celebrations of black people in the streets, I had to shake my head. Not because these black people were in the streets hooping, hollering, and celebrating without social distancing in the COVID-19 pandemic, but because most of these black people were hooping, hollering, and celebrating over the fact that they're going to get absolutely nothing in exchange for their vote. Now, the argument many black people were given as related to voting for Joe Biden was that they needed to vote for Joe Biden because your Donald Trump was a racist and a bigot. Now, that argument, as I see it, doesn't really wash, because when you take a critical examination of Joe Biden's policies over the 47 years that he's been in office, you can see how racist and white supremacist those policies were as related to black people, especially as related to black men. Because your Joe Biden's policies that he implemented, such as the discrepancy between crack cocaine and powder cocaine in the 1980s, and his Drug Abuse Act of 1986, this was the laying the foundation for the incarceration of black men. Not to mention the 1994 crime bill, which was another building block in that foundation of oppressing black men, which led to the creation of the prison industrial complex, which led to hundreds of thousands, even millions of black men winding up incarcerated and then used as slave labor inside of the prison system. On top of that, your Joe Biden was key in writing legislation such as the Three Strikes and You're Outlaw, which made it where a black man, usually if he committed a third offense, even if it was a misdemeanor, was going to wind up in prison for the rest of his life. So how is it that people are hooping, hollering, and celebrating about your Joe Biden, even though your Joe Biden created policies that directly oppressed black people? That's a critical question I want to ask all those black people who are celebrating and talking about how we've gotten rid of the evil orange man, but we're not looking at your Joe Biden's track record, nor are we looking at who your Joe Biden is associated with in the past. People like Strom Thurmond, a member of the Dixiecratic white supremacists, and others who were core instrumental in creating policies during Jim Crow, which kept black people in a permanent second underclass. This is something that just is not black people are thinking about critically as related to Joe Biden. They're getting caught up in their emotions over rhetoric in the media without thinking critically about the rhetoric they're listening to. Now, when I look at those masses who are out here celebrating the election of Joe Biden, it reminded me a lot of all of those black people out here who were celebrating the election of Barack Obama. And back then, most of those black people thought they had accomplished something because America had elected its first black president. But over the course of 8 years, they soon found out that that was one big okey-doke, because while they got a symbolic victory in electing America's supposed first black president, that black president did not do much for black people in terms of providing tangibles or providing policy that protected black people from anti-black racism. And again, that's why I find it mind-boggling that you had all of these black people celebrating in the streets about a man who created anti-black policies and thinking that they finally defeated racism by electing a man who created racist policies that were against black people. It just shows me how there was some cognitive dissonance in the minds of many of these black folks out here, and how many of these black folks, whenever they see a elderly white man on the left, they start to automatically believe that this white man is going to be a savior. And the way some of these people acted, it was basically like your Joe Biden was a new form of Jesus, and he was going to come down and be this Messiah who was going to be giving them his gift of salvation by just being there, again, sating their emotions, but never promising any of those black people any sort of tangibles in exchange for their vote. So most of these black folks, when I'm looking at them, they're sitting there thinking, oh, we've elected Joe Biden, we've stopped racism, but all you've done is go back to the status quo of hope and change. And by doing that, you show that, one, the definition of insanity is doing the exact same thing and expecting a different result. And two, you show how many black Americans are codependent on white supremacy, because only a codependent individual is going to go back to an abuser and believe that the abuser is going to treat them better. Because that's what I see with most of these black Americans who are hooping, hollering, and celebrating. They were sitting there talking about going back to the massa because they wanted to go back to that system of abuse because they were comfortable in that system of abuse. So when I look at many of these black folks out here who are hooping, hollering, and celebrating, I can clearly see some sort of mental illness there, because you're sitting there hooping, hollering, and celebrating the election of a man who created policies that were completely against you, and then you're going to elect this man by an 80% majority of black men and a 92% majority of black women, and you're thinking that you've accomplished something, but the political process doesn't follow your whole approach, because you're supposed to get something in exchange for your vote that is tangible, whether it be economic resources in the form of earmarks that are designated to your community to take care of municipal services and maintain the quality of life, legal policy that ensures that your group's rights are protected, or legislation and judicial precedents that ensure that your group's interests are protected. But did black people receive any of those things in exchange for their vote? No. And the reason why they didn't receive anything in exchange for their votes was because many of these codependent individuals have been battered into believing that an emotion is more important than their tangibles, and that that feeling good is something that has value. Because most of these black folks, they want to feel good for the moment, and they don't think about the future as related to their decisions. So they're sitting there feeling good about Joe Biden being the president of the United States and defeating the evil orange man. But that they don't understand is that they have exchanged one white supremacist for another, and neither was doing anything for black Americans at all. I mean, your Donald Trump, he promised to give black people a new deal, but in the 4 years he was in office, black people got absolutely nothing in exchange for that vote. Maybe they got a few things that's related to prison reform with Kanye West here or there, but we didn't get much in return for our votes. And with Joe Biden, you're going to get the same amount of nothing because you want to feel good, but you don't want to demand better. And many black folks, I believe, don't want to demand better because they would rather seek white validation and they would rather be at the bottom of the white supremacist system than be at the top of their own system. And that's how codependents really behave, because when your codependent battered wife is out here, she would rather be at the bottom of an abusive relationship than be an equal partner in an interdependent relationship, because she has to take responsibility for herself in an interdependent relationship with a decent, responsible man. And she has to be accountable for herself with that responsible man. And that's why she does not want the relationship with the responsible man. And when I look at many black folks today, they have the same codependent mindset. They would rather be at the bottom with white supremacy and think that they've accomplished something, but when in actuality, they haven't accomplished anything except empty symbolism that makes them feel good, but doesn't make them grow. Now, people will say, oh, the Trump presidency was a dark period, but that period was one where America had to take a look in the mirror at itself, and it had to take a look at the realities as related to what this country was all about. And that was one of the positives of the Trump presidency. Unfortunately, most Americans could not stand the pain of looking in the mirror the way an addict has to look in the mirror at themselves when they hit rock bottom. And your Americans would rather go back to the delusion of hope and change called Build Back America and think that they're going to build back, but all you're going to do is build back another structure with the same white supremacy and racism in between the bricks and mortar. And you're going to do that because you refuse to acknowledge the problem, and the Trump presidency was going to make you go through the pain that was going to help you acknowledge the problem. And that's the problem with most black Americans these days. They don't want to acknowledge the problem of racism. They want to go back to sleep. They want to go back to denying that this is the way the country is. And they want to go out here and again be complicit with this delusion, thinking that this is going to lead to change when this is going to be the exact same thing. And again, the definition of insanity is doing the exact same thing and expecting a different result. And that's why your Building Back America was not going to lead to any change, just like your hope and change didn't lead to any change. So there's no hope of building back a better America because Americans just don't want to acknowledge what makes America a mess to be a part of. Now, if you want to see me make more videos like this, you can donate to my Patreon, my PayPal, or my Cash App by clicking the links in the description box. And if you want to try some of my SJS Direct publications, which feature positive images of black people, like the ISIS series, the Esteem series, the John Haynes series, and the books of the Spinsterella trilogy, and my men's issues, books like The Man Crisis, you can find all those books on Amazon.com in paperback and Kindle format. That's all I have to say for this video. You can comment, rate, and subscribe.